I would like to call upon Richa ma'am to welcome one and all.
A very warm and pleasant evening to one and all present here. I welcome you on behalf of NH Goel World School. Abhivyakti has always been a very, very special day for each one of us, and especially for parents, because you get to see various performances by your children. Whatever they learn throughout the year during numerous activities, you all watch them today. So, without taking much of your time, I'll call upon my little comparers to take the show. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. May I request everyone to please stand up for the school anthem? Down 17 goals known as global goals, which will help us to achieve a better and more sustainable future. Keeping these goals in mind, Standard 2 had decided to take goal 14, life below water, as their theme for Abhivyakti this year. Our friends are sending out a message that underwater animals are suffering unnecessarily due to no fault of theirs. So let's join our hands to save the underwater animals.
Ganga हमारी देश की सबसे पवित्र और मुख्य नदी है. यह हमारी आस्था का प्रतीक है. गंगा नदी केवल नदी नहीं, हमारी संस्कृति भी है. गंगा नदी को सभी भारतवासी अपनी माँ की तरह पूछते हैं. इसकी पवित्रता का वर्णन हमारी प्राचीन ग्रंथों में भी किया गया है. तो आइए हमारे मित्र इस पवित्र गंगा नदी के दर्शन कराने जा रहे हैं.
कृष्णमाराधयामि सकल कलुष भंगे स्वर्ग सोपान संगे सकल कलुष भंगे स्वर्ग सोपान संगे तरल तर तरंगे देवी गंगे प्रसीदा स्वर्ग की परछाइयां दिखती तेरे आंचल तले, माँ तेरी हर बूंद में बहती हुई ममता मिले। तू है तेरी तन पे फेरे, मन को भी निर्मल करे। जिस तरह को तू छुए, जीवन से उसको सींच दे। लेके आया है कोई बस पाप तुझको सौंपने, फिर भी तू बहती चले सबको लगा करके गले। स्वाद अमृत का तुझे ही चूम कर जाना प्रसीदा, 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 प्रसीदा। नमामि गंगे, 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 नमामि गंगे।
धन्यवाद, बहुत ही अच्छी प्रस्तुति। जल हमारे जीवन के लिए अत्यंत आवश्यक है। हम सभी बिना खाने के थोड़े दिन जी सकते हैं, लेकिन बिना जल एक पल भी नहीं जी सकते। जैसा कि आप सभी जानते हैं, जल का मुख्य स्रोत वर्षा है। तो आइए हमारे मित्र इस सुंदर गीत के द्वारा बादलों से विनती कर रहे हैं कि हे काले बादल, हमें भरपूर पानी दो, खूब बरसो, जिसे कहीं भी पानी की कमी ना रहे।
Yeah.
pollution, garbage everywhere. I can't breathe.
It's not only air, but water is also getting polluted. It's not only humans. We are also harming the animals living in water.
Can't we do something to stop this pollution?
Let us witness a skit to see how water pollution is harming our sea creatures.
Something that is wasted day in and day out. Something that is misused without a doubt.
Something that is polluted by people all around.
Something that needs an every drop count.
One fine morning, deep down under the ocean, a tiny little baby dolphin was sad.
Mommy, this oil is covering my body. There is plastic and garbage all around. My eyes and skin irritate all day. It's difficult to breathe, it's difficult to play. Can't you provide me a safer and cleaner place to live?
Yes, baby. It seems as if all the garbage and other waste of the land is poured into our home here.
Mama, does it mean that the land is a better place to live in now?
With this hope, dear, we decide to leave the ocean and go to the shore.
This news of dolphins leaving the ocean spread like fire in the jungle.
We cannot afford to lose our good friends.
Yes, let's go and convince them to stay back.
The seaweed is always greener in somebody else's lake. You dream about going up there, but that is a big mistake.
Just look at the world around you. So many wonderful things around you.
Up on the shore, they work all day. Out in the sun, they slave away.
And one day when the boss gets hungry, guess who's going to be on the plate?
Thank you, friends, for your love and concern. I know we may die soon on the land, but don't you think all the plastic and pollution here is anyways killing us? It's better we go up there and sacrifice our life. I agree that ocean is the best place for us to live. It has always been. Water and the animals living in it were worshipped. So before we continue to live here, let us ask our fellow living human beings if they will improve their conduct towards us. Will you be sensitive enough to take care of us and our habitat?
Will you?
that we promise to value more.
Something we can save and preserve for sure.
Something that can protect our aquatic life.
Something we must hold on in order to survive.
Such a wonderful performance. Who doesn't like to play and splash in the water? Everyone does. But wait, is everyone happy? No. What about the underwater animals? Are they safe and happy? Come, let's find out through the next song.
Thank you.
Now, there's a fashion show coming up.
A fashion show?
Wow! Wait, it's not a usual fashion show. It's an unusual fashion show where we have the underwater creatures, some of which are endangered, telling us to save them or soon they would be extinct.
Let the show begin.
I am cold-blooded, and my body temperature fluctuates according to the water temperature. I also have a special quality. I can sleep in water without sinking.
Great, that makes you so special, and I like you.
We mermaids have a tail of fish and upper half of woman. We are mythological creatures.
Dolphin, you love to talk with your friends, right?
Yes, we click whistle and make other sounds.
Hello, I am a crab. Do you know I can swim and walk sideways?
And I think you live in coastal area of salty, fresh or brackish water.
Yes, that's true.
I am frog.
Do you sleep with your eyes open?
Yes, we have the ability to see in different directions.
I am a crocodile or reptile.
You know, they have the strongest bite force.
Hello, I am sea turtle. We live every ocean.
You know, 6 of the 7 species of sea turtle are endangered.
Hello, I am jellyfish.
Hey jellyfish, you are looking like an umbrella.
You will be surprised to know that though my name is jellyfish, I am not a fish.
Hello, I am shark, the largest fish in the sea.
And what about your teeth? You never brush, right?
There is no need of brushing. After each breath, I replace my teeth.
The tongue of blue whale weigh as much as an elephant.
Yes, that's true.
There are 300 species of octopus, usually located in tropical and temperate ocean waters.
They have a hard beak and 3 hearts.
Hi, I am starfish.
Do you have any other name?
Yes, we are also known as sea stars.
So, you are a star of seas.
I'm a clownfish.
You know their group is called school. And their leader is a dominant female.
Hey,
I am Swan. We are the largest member of the duck and goose family.
A male swan is called a cob, and a female swan is called a pen.
Hello everyone, I am Penguin, a flightless bird.
You can stay underwater for around 20 minutes at a time.
For the superb and informative performance. Now it's time to have a glance at the celebration, events, class activities and excursions taking place all around by children of grade 2.
universal understanding.
To share his thoughts.
Namaskar. पिछले 40-50 मिनट में हमने आज बहुत कुछ देखा और देखते देखते मैं यही सोच रहा था कि हमारे बच्चे हमें क्या कह रहे हैं और दिमाग में बहुत सारे सोच आ रही थी मुझे और अपने आप से मैं यही पूछ रहा था कि जब हम बाज़ार में जाके एक पानी का बोतल ख़रीदते हैं और जब पानी ख़त्म हो जाता है तो पानी का बोतल जाता कहाँ है, हमें ये तो मालूम है कि कहाँ से आ रहा है, दुकान से आ रही है, हम 10 रुपये देते हैं, 15 रुपये देते हैं, ले तो लेते हैं, उसके बाद वो जाता कहाँ है। और इसके साथ साथ शायद हमें दिखता है कि हमारे बच्चों को एस्मा हो रहा है, ब्रीदिंग प्रॉब्लम हो रहा है और वो खांसते हैं। मैं एक सर्वे भी करना चाहता हूँ कि हमारे स्कूल में कितने ऐसे बच्चे हैं जिनके आँखों में चश्मा लगा हुआ है। आई एम सॉरी टू हैव स्टार्टेड दिस टॉक विद दीज काइंड ऑफ थॉट्स बिकॉज दिस इज सो एपरेंट टू अस राइट नाउ और जब तक हम इसको बार बार नहीं दोहराएंगे हमें ये शायद समझ में नहीं आएगा कि हम इन्हीं के भविष्य के बारे में बात कर रहे हैं। और अगर आपके बच्चे आपके घर पे जाके कहते हैं कि नहीं पापा या मम्मी हमें शायद एक ही बॉटल इस्तेमाल करना चाहिए, बार बार नहीं नए बॉटल इस्तेमाल करें, तो शायद हमें सुन लेना चाहिए क्योंकि हम हमारे बच्चों के लिए एक स्वच्छ भविष्य चाहते हैं। हम चाहते हैं कि वो खुशी खुशी अपनी ज़िंदगी जिए, हेल्दी रहे और उसके लिए हमें आज से ही कदम उठाने पड़ेंगे। और इसीलिए हमने इस साल गांधी जी जो हमको बोल के गए हैं और सस्टेनेबल डेवलपमेंट गोल्स जो हमें कहता है यूनाइटेड नेशंस, इन दोनों को मद्देनजर रखते हुए हमने बच्चों से ये मैसेज आपके तक पहुंचाने की कोशिश की है। और ये मैसेज सिर्फ ये बच्चे ही नहीं लेकिन शायद हम स्कूल में हर रोज़ ही बातचीत करते हैं, टीचर्स बातचीत करते हैं, बच्चे आपस में बातचीत करते हैं और ज़रूरत ये है कि हम भी बातचीत करें इसको लेके। सो आई थिंक I don't want to take a lot of your time, but if you can put your hands together for all the children who put up this wonderful presentation. Once again, I would like you to put up your hands together for all the teachers who are working behind the scenes for these children. And finally, this is the first year when we are having Abhivyakti inside an auditorium also, right? So therefore, it's a very, very important year for us that we have been able to inaugurate an auditorium where we are going to see lot more presentations. These children will come up again and again on the stage with such strong messages that we will not be able to ignore them. So thank you. Thank you very much for coming. It's a full house, and I really wish all of us a wonderful future. Thank you. Thank you very much.
So good evening, everyone present here. This evening, it's a special evening for us. Pehli baar, jaisa principal sir ne bataya, ki hum logon ne is auditorium mein aap logon ko bulaya hai. Is saal se ek nayi shuruaat hai. Class first standard se leke, is saal third tak, maybe next year fifth tak ke bache, apni apni class ki presentation karenge. क्योंकि जब हम पूरे स्कूल की प्रेजेंटेशन करते हैं तो छोटे बच्चे 8 या 10 मिनट इनको टोटल मिलता है. एग्जीबिशन में ज़रूर भाग लेते हैं लेकिन उनका जो एक्चुअल टैलेंट है वो निखर के आता नहीं, आप लोगों को नज़दीक से देखने नहीं मिलता. तो ये ऑडिटोरियम जो अब बन गया है, हम इसका ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा उपयोग आने वाले सालों में करेंगे. The message today was to two messages actually. Save water, don't pollute it, and take care of marine animals or the animals which live underwater. मुझे याद है मैं बहुत छोटी बच्ची थी और मेरी नानी हमेशा एक लंबी जर्नी पे हम लोग जाया करते थे. और जब भी ये नदियाँ आती थीं, कुछ खास नदियाँ, जैसे जब दिल्ली आने वाला होता था तो अगर मैं सो रही होती थी तो जगा के मुझे जमुना जी में एक वो रुपया आता था उन दिनों चांदी का, या 8 आने या 1 रुपया जमुना जी में डलवाती थी. हम जब नर्मदा क्रॉस करते थे भरूच, सुबह के 3:30 बजे होते थे, पर फिर भी वो मुझे जगा के उसमें वो पैसा डलवाती. एक दफ़ा थोड़े टाइम के बाद मुझे बहुत गुस्सा आता था कि मैं इतना सो रही हूँ, मुझे उठा करके ये पैसा क्यों डलवाती हैं पानी में. तो ये पता चला, पूछने पे, झल्लाने पे ये जवाब मिला कि पानी जो है वो भगवान है. अगर पानी नहीं हो तो तुम्हें जीवन नहीं मिलता, और भगवान वो है जो जीवन देता है. मंदिर के भगवान ठीक है, पूजने के लिए ठीक हैं, देखने के लिए ठीक हैं, पर वो तुम्हें जीवन नहीं देते. जीवन पानी देता है, उसके बिना तुम रह नहीं सकते. इसलिए पानी में जब मंदिर में जाते हो तो पैसा चढ़ाते हो, तो मंदिर में जब पैसा चढ़ाते हो तो ये तो जीता जागता भगवान तुम्हें दिख रहा है, जिसको तुम फील कर सकते हो, उसको तो ज़रूर थोड़ा कुछ चढ़ाना चाहिए. वहाँ से ये समझ में आया. बहुत साल बाद कुछ ऐसे एक कविता मेरे हाथ आई, वो मैं आज आप लोगों के साथ शेयर करना ज़रूर चाहूँगी. क्योंकि तब से लेके आज तक हम अपने बच्चों को जो सिखाते हैं वो शायद सिखाते ऐसे नहीं हैं कि तुम ये सीखो, मैं तुम्हें सिखा रही हूँ या सिखा रहा हूँ, लेकिन हम शायद जो खुद करते हैं और जो बच्चे देखते हैं हमें करते हुए, या जो हम अपने जीवन में उतारते हैं, उनको हल्के फुल्के तरीके से समझा देते हैं, वो बच्चों के याददाश्त में कहीं ना कहीं रहता है. तो पानी मेरे लिए बहुत ज़रूरी है, और मैं कभी वो दिन और आज का दिन पानी को मैं कभी वेस्ट नहीं कर पाई. क्योंकि ये समझाया गया कि शावर से नहाओगी तो कितना पानी इधर उधर गिरेगा, तुम बाल्टी से नहाओ, एक बाल्टी में बहुत अच्छे से नहाती हो। शायद मैं 5.5-6 साल की थी, तब से लेके आज तक बहुत से देश हैं, बहुत से नगर हैं अक्रॉस द कॉन्टिनेंट्स जहाँ पानी नहीं है। Even today they are facing this problem. 2 years ago, I visited Cape Town and in the hotel room, we got only 500 milliliter water bottle, one bottle per day. In 24 hours, we were supposed to get only one bottle and we were told that your towels would not be washed. We stayed there for 10 nights and all those days we could not throw our towels for washing. Even in our taps, there were sensors for water usage because the city was undergoing, and now too it is absolutely under crisis. 2023 and most of our own cities will be without water. So this is something which is not future, it's very much today. And we can see it. So here's a poem which I would like to share with you. I liked it because the title is very much what my grandmother had taught me. God lives in the water. God lives in the water. He loves the shimmering droplets of life giving elixir, emanating from the tranquility of glaciers. He loves the stillness of the meandering streams and rivulets. He also enjoys the playfulness of mighty, ferocious rivers full of life within. He sleeps in deep slumber on his sheshaya, in spite of rumbling and roaring seas. I know it is hard for him, this human proximity, polluting all that is pure, polluting all that is pure in killing pursuit of life itself, threatening his very existence. Where will he go? Where will he go when he is homeless? Will he turn his back on the recklessness and forsake us? And will make his abode in the skies above. I thought God lives in water. I still believe that God lives in water. And I would like him to stay there. Because who has seen the skies above? Thank you. And I have a small little request. See, once we sit outside and we talk amongst themselves, it doesn't make a difference. But in an auditorium, when our children are performing, they have put in so much of effort. So at that point of the time, if we just keep little restraint of our urge to talk, I would be very thankful for that in future. And please keep your mobiles off. That is something which is required. All right? Thank you so much for coming. And after the national anthem, all of you should proceed to the cafeteria for high tea. Thank you so much.
I would request everyone to please stand for the national anthem.